How can freelancers, and I'm asking this specifically for a freelancer who could be in content writing or graphic design, website development, UI, UX, whichever kind of freelancer, what are some best practices for them to land a client? Is it they should be very active on social media platforms, or they should be part of some community groups, or they should, start reaching out peer to peer, or maybe they should start doing some things like, talking to other freelancers and, running an affiliate sort of thing, or, commission-based kind of things. What really are some best practices that freelancers can adapt to get clients?
I would say all of the above, short answer, but slightly long answer. My favorite thing, and this is so underrated, oh my gosh, is remember when we started our conversation, we talked about informational and exploratory interviews. The same thing works for freelancers as well, because at the end of the day, we want to be paid, whether you're in a company or a full-time or whether you're a freelancer. So I would say, yes, be active on LinkedIn. You don't want to be like a dud with like zero profile, nothing. You want something there, right? And at the same time, what you want to do is make a list, 30, 40, 50 dream clients that you would love to work for, in your area, particularly geographically, because at the end of the day, with remote and all that is great, but it's taking time for people to change, right? Some have come from the dinosaur mentality that if you're not present in office, you're not working. Like that has been shaken up because of the pandemic. But does that mean they've bought it overnight? No, it even if it's a year later, they still have that mentality. So I would say make this list of 30, 40, 50 people. Start following them on LinkedIn. Okay. And see particularly the ones who are very active, which when I say active, I mean they post at least 2 to 3 times a week. If something resonates with you, start talking to them publicly. Do not slide into DMs and cold call and do all of that stuff. You can. It's just a huge amount of waste of your time and energy, because then it becomes a pure numbers game, and 1 out of 100 or 1 out of 200 will get back to you. And have those con and there's an art. Comments, there's an art. There's a science and there's an art. Don't be that person who says, "Great post. I like it. Agree." Add something. Add something thoughtful to the conversation, right? Either you agree with it and say why you agree with it. Reason number one, reason number two, beautiful. Or you can say, "This was fantastic. May I add something here?" And then add something. And the person, if you keep doing this 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, and Pawan is like, "I recognize this name now. Who is Sonal? Like, I want to interact with him," right? So if you do this, imagine 10 to 15 minutes every single day with the help of your phone. I mean, you couldn't have done this 20 years ago with a phone book, right? The green, yellow pages. You couldn't do it, but you can do it today. So do go out there and make the most of it. That's my favorite way, because your aim is not to stay on LinkedIn. Your aim is to get these people off of LinkedIn on a private conversation between the two of you. And when you get them in a conversation and they'll say, "Oh yeah, hi, I'd love to," you hit them up, right? When you see that how do you say in English? Strike when the iron is hot. I don't think you need to wait for the iron to be hot. Just wait for it to be warm enough. Don't waste time and then jump. Because when you send them a connection request on LinkedIn, do not be the lazy person who just clicks connect and leave. No, personalize the connection and say, "Why do you want to connect with them?" And talk about some of your favorite posts that they've done. And they'll be like, "Of course, I'll connect with you." And say, "Hey, I'd love to meet you one day." And they'll say, the chances of them saying yes are 90% higher because you're a familiar person. And then when you meet them, please don't sell your services to them. Please don't do it. If you're smart, you're active on LinkedIn, your content sells already. What instead you do is when you meet them, ask about their problems. Ask about their problems. People are not doing this enough. Everyone is interested in me. And they lead with what they want. "Hey, Sonal, can you check my CV?" Like, I don't know you from Adam. I'm telling you, Pawan, that only happens with people from India. So there is some training that has to be done where people are not told. It's not their fault. So they immediately like, "Oh yeah, I've liked her post 3 times. I'm a subscriber of your channel. And this is an, can you help me with this gigantic problem I have? And can you help me? I need the answer by tonight." Not gonna do it. Not gonna do it. I don't know you. But if there is a relationship, and the person will say, "I'll do whatever. I'll do something to help you out, right? But this, you don't ask first. Sorry, don't sell. Just instead ask them. And when they tell you their problems, you'll say, oh yeah, I have a recommendation. I have a friend who's actually a graphic designer who, you know, if you want, I'll make the introduction. And they'll say, that'd be amazing. Thank you so much. And then you're building a relationship. And then it's so much easier to say, hey, one day, you know, hey, I wanted your feedback as I'm working on this offer. Would you be open to take it slowly? Don't rush to the sale. Yeah. That would be my strategy.
Yeah.